Good evening, dear colleagues. I'm Dr. Marwa Ahmed Salah. I'm a lecturer of internal medicine, endocrinology unit, Faculty of Medicine, Alexandria University. Today, I would like to talk to you about the pituitary tumors. It's not very common, but we usually we classify pituitary tumors into functioning and non-functioning adenomas, where functioning adenomas are most of the cases, and the most common secretory pituitary tumors are prolactinomas, followed by growth hormone adenomas, and then ACTH secreting, and lastly TSH secreting pituitary adenomas. While non-functioning adenomas accounts for about one-third of the cases of all pituitary tumors. First, as regard the functional adenomas, usually the patients present with hormonal hypersecretion, whether hyperprolactinemia in case of prolactinoma, or acromegaly in case of cross hormone secreting adenoma, or Cushing disease in cases of ACTH secreting pituitary adenoma, and lastly secondary hyperthyroidism in cases of TSH secreting adenomas. While patients with non-functioning adenoma usually had late diagnosis because of they lack the hormonal hypersecretion, and usually they are presented late with macroadenoma and mass effects. As regard the investigations and treatment, usually we have to do the hormonal profile to assess all the pituitary hormones, and then we have to do the MRI pituitary cella to identify the lesion. Lastly, as regard the treatment, many of the pituitary adenomas are treated surgically, except for prolactinomas, which medical treatment is the first line treatment, including the dopamine agonist, cabergoline, or bromocriptin. We have other lines of treatment, such as medical treatment or radiotherapy, in cases who are have recurrence or residual tumor after surgery. And thank you.